The Fairly Oddparents, a show that was one of the most popular programs on Nickelodeon. It had fun animation, interesting stories, and hilarious characters.
Silence! What is the sound of one hand clapping?
I can't answer that either!
But, like many shows that go on for too long, it began to lose viewers and grew desperate to have them come back. From drastic character introductions to live-action movies to being canceled 5 times, The Fairly Oddparents truly went through the motions. But after 10 seasons, the writing is on the wall, and there's a very good chance that it won't be returning back to television. But what caused this decline? Who or what is responsible for the drop in quality and ratings? Was it the fault of the people who made the show? Or was this Nickelodeon's doing? Well, let's take a closer look at what ruined The Fairly Oddparents. In order to understand what ruined Fairly Oddparents, we need to go back and see where it came from. That would be with a fella named Elmer Earl Hartman IV, aka Butch Hartman. Butch grew up in Michigan, but eventually made his way over to CalArts. There, he would sharpen his skills as an animator, but his big break would come in the 1990s when he was hired at Hanna-Barbera. This proved to be an excellent environment for up-and-coming artists and show creators. Some of the talent that came from this group included Seth MacFarlane, Gendy Tartakovsky, Rob Renzetti, and Craig McCracken. Seth and Butch actually worked together on a short called Zoomates, and it was featured in Oh Yeah Cartoons.
I hope they don't release that baboon. He's got that exposed fanny. I heard that one of the storks looked at it for too long and he went blind.
Okay.
Around this time in the 90s, Fred Seibert was in charge of Hanna-Barbera, but left the company to form his own studio called Frederator. One of the shows it would develop was Oh Yeah Cartoons, a program that featured animated shorts and was aired on Nickelodeon in the late 1990s.
Oh yeah!
You're watching Oh Yeah Cartoons. Oh.
But out of all of the cartoons and talent that premiered on Oh Yeah Cartoons, none were as successful as Butch Hartman's Fairly Oddparents.
Hey, Timmy!
I'm Cosmo.
I'm Wanda.
And we're...
your Fairly Oddparents!
What do you think, Timmy?
I think I'm calling the cops.
The show made its debut in 1997 as a short, but was picked up by Nickelodeon as a full-fledged series in 2001. Off the bat, it was incredibly popular and quickly became one of the premier shows on the network. It was even able to give SpongeBob SquarePants a run for its money and surpassed it in ratings for a brief time in the early 2000s.
I don't care about the children! I just care about their parents' money!
The creation for Fairly Oddparents came from a place of urgency rather than deep inspiration. Butch was trying to pitch a show so he could be his own boss, and the idea for Fairly Oddparents was created on the spot.
I was working on Johnny Bravo, and this was back in 97. And Fred Seibert at Hanna-Barbera, he was doing the What a Cartoon series.
Yep.
All the short cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
And he was leaving to come over to Nickelodeon. And he said, hey, Butch, I'm starting basically the same thing at Nickelodeon. We're going to call it the Oh Yeah Cartoon series. You got any ideas?
Yeah.
But I was working on Johnny Bravo at the time. And I said, no, Fred, I'm kind of loyal over here to Johnny Bravo. I'm not going to leave. He goes, well, okay, well, the slots are filling up. Let me know when you have an idea.
Mm-hmm.
About 6-7 months go by. Johnny Bravo finishes. They're not picking it up. Now I don't have a job.
Right.
So I go, okay, I'm tired of working for other people. I'm going to come up with my own thing. Had no idea at all. And so I call up Fred. I go, you got any slots left? He goes, I have one slot left. And so I said, okay, hung up the phone and I sat at my desk and I just drew a little boy. I'm going to draw a cartoon about a little, you always write what you know. I'm going to write a cartoon about a little boy. And I had other ideas I'd been working on at the time, but I wasn't really happy with them. So I drew a little boy. It was Timmy Turner. I was going to name him Mike after my brother Mike, but we had a fight that day. So I, and all of this took, not kidding around, about 15 minutes.
I believe it.
I just drew it all like, this is kind of funny. And I pitched it to Hanna-Barbera and they turned it down.
Mm-hmm.
And Cartoon Network said, no, thank you. No.
Yeah.
And then Fred, I called Fred with the one slot open and I went over to Nickelodeon and pitched to him and he bought it.
The show itself is about a little boy named Timmy Turner. From bullies to parents to babysitters, he had it rough and never had any fun. Because of his misery, he was assigned 2 fairy godparents, Cosmo and Wanda. It is their job to grant him wishes in order to keep him happy.
The honest godparents.
parents, Fairly Odd Parents.
Wands and wings,
floaty crowny thing.
I was only a kid when Fairly Odd Parents first aired on Nickelodeon. And personally, I loved the show. It had a fun premise, great jokes, pleasing animation, and was just overall a wonderful cartoon. It was easily one of my favorite programs on the network, and many other people felt the same way. It brought in millions of viewers, and maintained those numbers for the early and mid-2000s. There were also a decent amount of TV specials that would only increase the show's popularity. Heck, they even had a crossover with Jimmy Neutron.
Jimmy Neutron, boy genius.
Timmy Turner, boy!
The Fairly Odd Parents wouldn't be the only show that Butch would develop at Nickelodeon. In 2004, there was Danny Phantom, an action-based cartoon about a teenage boy with ghost-like powers. After that would be Tough Puppy in 2010, and then Bunsen is a Beast in 2017. Out of all of those cartoons, Danny Phantom was the most successful, but none of them were nearly as popular as the Fairly Odd Parents, though Danny Phantom would go on to have quite the cult following.
It's free real estate.
Like I said, the early 2000s were the golden years for the Fairly Odd Parents. The show was a critical and financial success and made lots of money for the network. But hard times were on the horizon, and corporate meddling became a serious problem for Fairly Odd Parents and its relationship with Nickelodeon. Fairly Odd Parents was one of the main cartoons on the network, but according to Butch, the executives at Nickelodeon had mixed feelings about the show. Throughout its runtime, Fairly Odd Parents was canceled 5 times, but the executives at Nick would eventually overturn the cancellations and ask Butch to continue on with the show.
We kept making the show. It did get canceled 5 times. They said, no more, you're all done. And just as I was finishing a season and thinking it was over, they would pick it up again because the ratings were so strong.
To me, this is one of the main reasons why Fairly Odd Parents began to decline. The executives at Nickelodeon were flip-flopping with the show and only desired to have a cartoon that was the same caliber as SpongeBob, both in ratings and flavor.
They say, Butch, you know what? I'm like, what? They say, we're canceling your show again. I said, well, why are you guys stopping it now? It's still not doing as well as the Sponge Show. The Sponge Show is our Mickey Mouse. Oh, hi, Pluto. Hi, Patrick. I'm SpongeBob. And now you're the Donald Duck of Nickelodeon.
Another issue that the Fairly Odd Parents ran into was franchise fatigue. The show has been going on for nearly 15 years, and it's only natural that it would run out of ideas. This is not uncommon, though, as other shows suffer the same problem, such as SpongeBob, Family Guy, and The Simpsons. I mean, it's only a matter of time until a program exhausts all of its practical options and has to take drastic measures in order to keep their audience entertained. This spiral for the Fairly Odd Parents began with the arrival of Poof in season 6. To many fans, this was the beginning of the end, though the ratings for the show shot up temporarily. But as time went on, the ratings would only continue to suffer, as the main audience that used to watch Fairly Odd Parents disappeared. A character named Sparky arrived in season 9 and was another attempt to recapture the attention of viewers. This proved to be unsuccessful though, as many viewers disliked the new character, so much so that he was removed from the show.
Well, Sparky, this is your new home.
I like it. I like you. I like everything. I like this chew toy.
One of the final changes made to the show was the arrival of Chloe Carmichael in season 10. She was a foil character for Timmy, as he was forced to share Cosmo and Wanda alongside her. But just like Sparky, this character did not really resonate with viewers. All they really saw was another attempt to regain their dying audience. According to Butch though, this was another intervention on behalf of the executives at Nickelodeon.
It came from a request from an executive at Nickelodeon. And this happens in TV sometimes. You know, when you've been doing a show as long as Fairly Odd Parents, I mean, Fairly Odd Parents premiered March 30th of 2001, ding, 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 ding. And 14, 15 years later, this exec at Nickelodeon, who kind of ran the whole place, said, you know, we really love Fairly Odd Parents. We want to keep making the show. And I'm like, great, but we want you to add a new character in the show, kind of a foil for Timmy Turner. We want you to add a girl character in the show that would probably give him a problem. And that's really all I was asked.
The more I researched this topic, the more I realized how controlling the executives are over at Nickelodeon. Yes, I understand that the profits are the bottom line at a network, and they won't feature cartoons just because they're good. They have to make a profit as well. But truth be told, SpongeBob really did a number at Nickelodeon. It cast a huge shadow, and it seemed like every other cartoon on the network was a stepchild that was constantly compared to it.
You're fired.
Well, I don't even work here.
Would you like a job starting now?
Why would I?
You're fired.
Franchise fatigue is also a very real problem. You can see this with all the changes Fairly Oddparents made over the years. Now, change does not mean it's automatically going to be bad, but more often than not, it is. And I haven't even mentioned A Fairly Odd Movie. It was a live-action TV film that starred Drake Bell and computer-animated versions of the fairies. Now, the movie itself had over 5 million viewers and had two sequels to boot, but it ultimately did not save the show from running out of steam.
You know what I'd really love is to get those first words out. Come on, buddy, let's hear them. What are they, Poof? Come on.
The only other factor that potentially contributed to the decline of the Fairly Oddparents is the death of television. Now, I've mentioned this before in previous videos, and how TV is on the way out. Most kids today get their entertainment from the internet, whether it be Netflix or YouTube. And as older viewers move on, new viewers decline and aren't as many as they used to be. This is a major problem for all television networks, and trust me, they know it. Season 10 was the final hurrah for the Fairly Oddparents. It aired from 2016 to 2017 and did not feature a grand finale. It just aired the episodes it had, and that was it. Overall, The Fairly Oddparents was a great show. Yes, it had a somewhat sour conclusion and went on for far too long, but if you focus on the high points, you see a show that's up there with SpongeBob, Hey Arnold, and Avatar. The demise of the show, though, really boiled down to a handful of things. 1. Franchise fatigue. It simply went on for too long and ran out of ideas. 2. Executive meddling. The suits at Nickelodeon kept poking the show with a stick in hopes of making more money and increasing their ratings for the network. And 3. The death of television. Technology is changing, and TV is being replaced by the internet. Kids really don't watch television anymore. They watch YouTube and Netflix. So all of these factors contribute to the fall of the Fairly Oddparents, and also many other shows. If cartoons want to survive in this current climate, they have to change how they are received. Netflix is doing a good job at this, and it seems that other companies are positioning themselves to do the same. As I said, season 10 was the last season for the Fairly Oddparents, and will most likely be the final season. After 15 years of service, Butch left Nickelodeon and is no longer involved in the creation of any of its shows. Now, Nick still owns the rights to the Fairly Oddparents and could technically bring it back, but I don't think that's likely anytime soon. But what about Butch? What's he been up to, and where did he go?
Internet?
Yep. Butch made the transition over to the internet and runs a YouTube channel. It's been interesting watching someone from his era get with the times. You can sometimes see the disconnect between him and his audience, but hey, at least he's trying. The guy is obviously very talented and has a lot of experience, but it comes from a completely different era of entertainment. Things have drastically changed with the arrival of the internet, and never before have people been so connected. There's a learning curve with all of this, and Butch is trying to keep up with the times.
Heart fans, what's up? Butch Hartman here, so glad you're here. Don't forget we do videos 3 times a week now, Mondays, Wednesdays, and fun days.
How do you do, fellow kids?
What?
He's also trying to kickstart a new streaming service that's family friendly, though there's some controversy surrounding it and the direction it's going. Some say it's doomed to fail since family friendly content is a taboo subject. Also, most streaming services already have a family friendly setting to serve that purpose. But once again, at least Butch is trying. Hopefully, he'll find a place that can utilize his experience, but with a modern spin. Also, Nickelodeon desperately needs to do the same if they hope to survive moving forward. If not, then Netflix and YouTube will just mow them down. Again, it's a shame that the Fairly Oddparents did not have a grand finale, but that's alright. Timmy, Cosmo, Cosmo and Wanda had their fun, but now it's time to make room for new ideas. Hopefully, these creators and companies will see the light, and we as viewers will get our wish. Hey guys, I just wanted to quickly thank my top tier sponsors on Patreon. Toongren, Chad Butler, Tyrion, Kerberry, Lex, Chumbawamba, Malkavio, Moondoggy, Illegally Sane, and Julius. Thank you all so much for your support.